Hello and welcome back to RailOn, where we are looking at our youngster roundabout station, which has freshly grown up to be big and be able to handle lots and lots of trains. And yeah, I think it looks quite good, and I have high hopes for it. And yeah, so far so good, right? Now, last time we left off by us looking over here at this roundabout station. And what we saw was a small pileup. And also, look, a train broken down. Another one broken down. And, well, I'm sure there's like, yeah, see, another one broken down. And I'm sure there's like countless more trains that are broken down. So, in between videos, I have had a thought about it all. And, well, here was it, you know. The decision on the whole breakdown meta is that, yeah, I am going to disable them. You may think it's cheesy, I actually think that myself too, but you know, the real thing with these breakdowns is that, you know, I enabled them for like, well, because I thought stuff breaks down. I remember it happening in the original, so it should also be here. But right now, really, it's just an annoyance. I can play with breakdowns. I've been doing it for 140 years almost, but right now, it's just annoying, and it makes a hell of a lot of noise, too. Because in the last few videos, I remember when looking over here at this station, all I would hear, especially in the zoomed out look like this, was breakdowns. I like to hear ka-ching, ka-ching, cash, cash, and more of that. But no, all I was hearing was stuff breaking down. And that's annoying, and well, you know, the game shouldn't be annoying, it should be enjoyable instead of annoyable. So, yeah, that's why I'm going to disable them. And since I have, maybe we should see an improvement in the flow of trains over here. Maybe it was, you know, this whole pileup here was just because of the breakdowns. I think not, though. I think we still need to improve this roundabout a bit, because I do have one ace up my sleeve, and to increase its traffic throughput capabilities a little bit. It's not going to be double the amount of what it's handling right now, but you know, it will enhance it a little bit. So yeah, first thing we'll do is we'll give this its final touches, you know, this big badass roundabout. So yeah, we'll do that now. Alright, so that's the final tuning to the big badass roundabout done. It isn't much, I know that as well, but what it really provides is just an extra bleed-off option. Say that, you know, once there's like a train crossing over here, then there's at least the option for trains to just escape over here, really, and use this track. Ah, it's a bit bad that we don't see it happening right now, you know, to prove my point, but, ah well. Anyway, yeah, and this is also, of course, oh look, there it goes, see? That's why we need it, otherwise things would have been going even slower through this station. So, yeah, that's all good and dandy now, but this is not like the main thing, right? Because what I want to do today, really, as the big thing, is build the new station that I was raving about last video. And well, because of this we didn't really got to it, but right now we will. This town over here, what was it called? Muhattan? Really? I thought, is that the right town? Or am I looking at a wrong town here? don't know, I thought... Oh, yeah. This is the wrong town. Herp derp. This is the right town over here. Grunley. Yeah, Grunley. This was the chosen town, and maybe it likes it, maybe it doesn't. Well, let's see. Oh, we don't even have any ratings, alright. Anyway, yeah, this is the town. Now, what we will do here is build a new station design. And it will be a multi sounds really good, but it's actually a bi-directional station, where trains can enter from both sides and without having to use bridges or crossings or whatever. Well, obviously there will be crossings, but they won't have to use bridges, so it should be a lot more efficient. So at least that's the idea. So yeah, about that station, huh? I'd say we start building it so you can see what I'm talking about, because I could be explaining this all day, but then you still wouldn't have a clue about what I'm on about. So here it goes. Yeah, I think that we do have a small problem here now though. That is, yeah, ratings, right? Because, well, I need to build another station over here, but I think that we might have a small issue with getting that built over there. I'm not entirely sure, but my suspicion is that... if I build it over here then? Wait, it does need to be symmetrical. Symmetrical! Yeah, that should be doing it. Yeah, I was afraid this would happen. The local authorities are not all that happy with us anymore, and I can't blame them because I just cratered up their nice panoramic landscape. But there is, however, a method of fixing that, and it's called trees. Because for some reason, trees are always the good guys in games. You know, we have Roller Coaster Tycoon, and apparently here as well. But look, see? The ratings go up, and by quite a bit as well. We're already poor. If we are mediocre, I believe, we can build the station again, so... Yeah, look, right now we are mediocre! Alright. Someone in the comments said that trees are really good for fixing up your ratings, and, well... Point proven, I think, so... Alright. This is where we need this to be. Wow, let's just... Oh! Oh man, I wouldn't even want to live here, man. Look at this, the whole town is just gone, you know, it's hidden from away by the forests. Oh man, yeah, this isn't all that good now, is it? So, anyway, yeah, we're gonna start out small, just to see if the concept works, because, well, very nice concept, isn't it? No, but the thing is, I haven't built this before, so I don't need to kind of, you know, have a kind of proof of concept, really, for myself. So, yeah, that's why I'm building it small first, but this should be really easy expandable as well. And expandable, really, in, like, big numbers, you know? Like, we could easily tag on, well, till here and till this radio tower, more or less. That would be, like, 50 station tracks. Which is way more than we'll probably ever put on here, but oh well. Anyway, yeah, so about the station, right? Let's finish it up. right, ladies and gentlemen, here it is, the bi-directional station. Now, as I said, we're starting out small, so 8 tracks is indeed small, but look at this. I think that this is a masterpiece of signaling. And, well, it could also be a real crap piece when trains start crashing into each other, but they should not be able to do that, in theory at least. And, well, you know, basically these pathing signals should allow trains to enter each track from multiple, or you know, from both directions. And yeah, they should also be able to exit to both directions, as they can go from this track to this lane and the other way around, really. So yeah, now in terms of, you know, station placement and design layout, if you take a look at the bigger picture over here on the map, you can see that really what we've done is we've run a track parallel over here. Now originally I had this station type in mind, but to have it be in between these two tracks, you know, these main track lines. However, yeah, they're quite far apart, so this is like the next, you know, the solution I came up with, but really, ideally, I'd have hook up over here directly and over here, but that's not the case, so this will have to do. Now, we don't have any trains running towards it right now, and yeah, I think we should start up this station slowly but surely. So, first thing we'll do is we'll fire it up with one train. we'll make like a batch of 4 trains, and yeah, we'll have to see how that goes. I don't really know, it's really experimental, but so far I think it's looking quite slick, and this is also really easy to expand. I could just tag on more stations and expand this more over there, and yeah, it should all be easy to manage, really. At least, that's the idea. Of course, we haven't seen any practice yet, so... Alright, full load all the cargoes. I am curious though, because a thing I've wondered about when I was upgrading this is that all these stations are outside of the range of this sawmill. So I'm actually wondering like whether or not we will actually get any goods on this station. It's quite essential when you are hauling goods. Also, we should group this, because I do want our goods trains to be separated. You know, like a group for the sawmill goods and a group for the factory goods. So since we'll be cloning this train only, if I put him over here once, we should be all good. So we'll start with 4 trains, and we'll also start with like 4 trains on the other side. But yeah, this is it really. Now obviously we are gonna, you know, 4 trains is like not even a fraction of the capacity that will, or the amount of trains that will be running through this station once it's fully up and running. But this is also more of like a test really, and so far it does seem that these 2 tracks at least work. So yeah, well, that's at least something. Yeah, we'll set up this as well over here. We'll group this up too and all that stuff. Now I also know that last video we had the whole void order mystery going on, and well, I remember saying very certain of my cause that we, you know, it was only affecting a few trains. Well, that wasn't really true. It was affecting all the wood trains, because I also found out what I did wrong really, and that was that I had removed the baby roundabout station and replaced it with a different station name. Yeah, you know, I think it at first it was called like, what's it called now? Oh crap, I'm looking at the wrong station, but it was called like something central, and now it's like something woods, or, you know, so it was really just that causing mischief among the orders. So I had to fix all freaking 78 trains. So yeah, Anyway, factory goods. Yeah, my multitasking capabilities are astounding. Let's see. So, factory goods. There we go. Clone this another 4 times. And good. Wow, just hear that. Also, we've bid this for quite a while now, but yeah. It really seems to me that we are just using this station to its max capacity, really. I can't think of any other reason for there being so many traffic jams. I mean, look at it, man. Traffic jam is extending, like, from the junction all the way up here. And it's not because of breakdowns, because our trains can't break down anymore. So, yeah, kind of crappy. Do we need, like, another switch in between? Maybe we do, actually, you know? Because the middle lane hardly has any traffic. Yeah, one stray train every now and then, but the outer lane is just jam-packed, really. Question is, though, where would we put that? Because it does mean, like, a bulge on the tracks. It would be nice. Ah well, we'll take care of that later. For now, I want to focus on this new station. So, it is handling stuff pretty well, so far. So, now is it? Yeah, see? Here's what I was afraid of. We're not getting any goods on this station. And that's not good. So, but I know an easy way to fix it. Luckily, I know a lot about this. It's a kind of a ghost station, really, but if I link it up over here, right now, we should start seeing... Yeah, look, goods. See, now they are loaded onto our trains. So, that's pretty good. So, yeah, I think we could do with, like, another set of trains, really. I think, in fact, if we run with 20 trains over here, we should more or less keep up with the good production that we have at the moment. So, let's see here. This is another batch of 4. That makes a total of 8. Then, another batch of 4. So now we're on 12. Another batch of 4. 16. And another batch of 4. Alright. Good. So, in theory, we have 20 trains running now on a meager 4 tracks. Well, not really, of course, because they can also use this. So, in theory, we have 20 trains running on 8 tracks. That seems quite reasonable, actually. Also, right now, you can see that the town is not growing. But, once we get, like... oh, and you saw that, because there was a train leaving the depot over here. Right now, they're using the overflow tracks. Anyway, what I was saying is that right now, the town's not growing, but once they receive the goods, they should start to grow. Grow? Please? Maybe I need to refresh this window. No. Weird. It should grow. Really? Right? Please grow? Oh, and look, these trains over here are arriving here now. The only real test case for this station would be if a train is on a track coming from this direction and another one's just going over here. What would happen, you know? I'm quite curious. Because obviously it would be kind of a bad thing if that happened. Because they would, you know, they would be like both facing each other, trying to go to opposite directions. Oh yeah, look at this. Right now, the town is growing every 200 days, and that's solely because we are transporting goods to it. So, good stuff, and look at this. A big, massive flow of goods trains, really. And we are having some issues over here. Yeah, so here's the thing. I think that... Well, I just built it, but already I think that we need to go to like a 4-lane situation, really. Or a duo-lane situation. Four lanes in total. because what we're seeing right here is like, well, trains need to climb slopes and join, and that's causing traffic jams in the roundabout, and that is like the last place where I want traffic jams. So yeah, we will upgrade the entrance and exit tracks from this side so that it can handle a lot more trains, really. The U-Town are notoriously in the way, actually. I don't like it at all, not in the slightest. Oh well, not much we can do about it. Oh, this is not all that helpful either. Stupid tower. Oh well. Anyway, yeah, so... Okay, so we just got like two lane tracks only leading from the exit of this roundabout, but look over here. We have fixed the issue more or less, did we now? No, we have not actually, because balls. Yeah, see, what I really need as well is like an option, like an option B, so to say. Like, well, really, what I just derped up here is the order of tracks, really. What I really need is, like, this track to be on this side. Crap. Alright, I'll quickly fix this. I think I just got it fixed now, though it does seem that most of the trains are right now using this other track. Well, we should see some proper distribution now, really. But yeah, there it is. One-sided, well actually it's triple day now, but yeah, obviously we need to upgrade the rest as well, though I think that the most imminent tracks to upgrade were these exit tracks because of all the slopes they had to make, really. But right now, the way it should work is that once this is like filled up because of the waiting they have here, and they should really start to use this track over here. At least that's how it should work, but we will have to find out, I guess. Anyway, regardless, and now that we got the whole goods operation, well, started really, I wouldn't say that this is the final version or anything, let's take a look over here. Oh my god, look at this, we almost, well, we increased our profits by like 500 million, oh my god, in only 4 years' time. Mind you, that is just crazy, absolutely crazy. And then so far, yeah, I'm really liking this whole new station design too, if I'm honest. So that's a, well, I'd say it's a success so far. We haven't really put it under a true load yet, so to say. But so far things do look promising, I have to admit. And, well, yeah. Another thing I'm quite curious about is how's the traffic jam over here going? Well, still going strong, it seems. Yeah, unfortunately. Even though we have these new bleed-out options, and look, see, they're used as well. We still have an X... Yeah, we do, wow, we just have too many trains. It's crazy. How many do we have? 237 trains, though. That is an... Wow, I just have no words for it, really. Though a lot of them do experience traffic jams over here. Yeah, not just any... Wow. This is really, really bad. Traffic jams extending across the junction. Yeah, we have to address that. But we will do that next time when we play more OpenTTD. So join me then.